What's the best way to protect yourself from burglary? That's what we're talking about now. Hi, I'm Chris, and today I'm going to talk to you about two things. First, how does burglary protection not work, so you know what to avoid? And second, how does burglary protection really work? It's all about the difference between mechanical and electronic burglary protection. Let's first talk about measures against burglary, what doesn't work. So let's start with what measures are not very effective for protecting against burglaries. Have you ever been told that getting a dog will scare away burglars? Well, the truth is that most dogs are harmless and playful, so they only work to some extent as burglary protection. Many people do believe that their family dog will protect them from burglars, but unfortunately, that is only partly true. If you're interested in diving deeper into this topic, you can check out my video called Dogs as Burglary Protection, which I'll link to you in the upper right corner. Let's move on to the second point. Lockable window handles. I have talked about this in another video, but wanted to bring it up again. Lockable window handles can be useful if you lock them properly. In that case, a burglar would make a hole in the size of a hand into your window pane and then break open the window handle. Not everybody can do that, and burglars don't always have the time. But if you don't feel like locking all your windows every time you leave the house, well, that's what you have to do. Imagine you have about 20 windows in your home. You have to walk through the whole house, lock all the windows, take out the keys and put them somewhere. And you do that every time you go, for example, shopping, or if you go out to take a walk with a dog, for example. And if you come back, you have to do the same procedure again. What about if you forgot to lock the windows? You should ask your insurer if you have still coverage if you did forget to lock all of the windows. From my experience, hardly anyone does that in a large house with many rooms and many windows. Now let's move on to the third point, which is the most important one. I want to talk about electronic burglary protection. Electronic measures can be helpful, but they do not replace mechanical burglar protection. Just because you install an alarm system does not mean burglars will leave then when the alarm rings. Cameras are often used to solve crimes and can deter opportunistic offenders. However, professional burglars are a different story. False alarms are also a significant issue. By the way, a friend of mine told me about his vacation in the south of France. He set his alarm system to send notifications to his phone and Apple Watch, and even transmit a camera image. During his vacation, the alarm kept going off without any reason within a few days. Eventually, he started ignoring the alarm. What if one of those alarms had actually been triggered by a burglar? Especially in the case of properties where burglars expect a big loot, like villas and large family houses, burglaries are often planned well in advance. Burglars then might know the blind spots of cameras and are aware of the presence of alarm systems. They find out when no one is home and plan their burglary accordingly. And they could also overwhelm alarm systems. By the way, have you ever noticed what happens when a car alarm goes off in the streets? Nothing, right? People might look briefly, but no one really cares. If you have attentive neighbors who are at home, they might react when the alarm goes off in your house. But what if your house stands alone, or your neighbors simply are not there? You also need to ask yourself how long it will take for security guards or police to get to your house after the alarm goes off. After all, once the burglar is inside, it often takes only a few minutes and he will quickly disappear. In conclusion, an alarm system may deter opportunistic burglars, but it won't necessarily stop a professional burglar. That's why electronic burglary protection can only even be an addition for mechanical measures, which I'll discuss in a moment. Second, let's talk about what you need to avoid. But before I'll tell you what measures really help against burglaries, a few quick tips on what to avoid. First, leave a key outside. As I said before, Many burglars spy on property before attacking it. If you hide a key outside, a burglar might see that. And also, burglars know the most common key hiding places anyways. So be careful with this. Second, also avoid that your house shows that you are on vacation. For example, modern blinds could be automatically opened and closed at different times, for example in the morning and in the evening hours, without you having to be at home. It is also a good idea to always park your car in the garage so that if your car is gone for a while, it's not immediately obvious that you're gone. Third, always close all windows when you leave the house. By the way, tilted windows are very easy for burglars to open and are just as an open window basically. Fourth, another important point to remember is not to leave ladders laying around. It's like inviting burglars in, especially in combination with a tilted window, for example, on the second floor. This creates a perfect opportunity for them. You should also secure your balcony and upper floors as well. These places should not offer good climbing, otherwise the balcony will be a burglar's dream. Because there, in contrast to the ground floor or the front door, he is less visible from the outside and can break open a window on a balcony door very easily. Such vegetation here, for example, is not good. A layperson could climb up these vines without any problems. Many burglaries happen through the upper floors, so you must not leave your upper windows and your skylights open when you leave the house. The windows above the garage, for example, are very easy accessible. Somebody could climb up there and access the house through the upper window then. What does work especially well? So now it's getting specific. What can you really do to stop burglars? First of all, the most important basic rule. What we really need to confront burglars with is time. That's it. Lots of time. Because the longer it takes a burglar to get in, the more likely they give up. Cameras, alarms, and dogs may scare off opportunistic burglars. But you have to remember, there are of course also professional burglars. And professional burglars might not go away. That's why you need mechanical burglar protection. I am not the only one to say this. It is definitely police forces advising you to do so. Always with the motto, mechanical burglary protection comes before electronic burglary protection. So what exactly do you need now to effectively protect your home? The biggest weak points on your house are windows and doors. According to crime statistics in Germany, almost 80% of burglaries happen through windows and balcony and patio doors, about 20% on front doors. Therefore, you need to protect these parts of the house. There are three criteria you can use to determine whether your house is well protected. First, the door including frame and lock. There are different resistance classes for house and apartment doors which keep burglars away. Depending on the resistance class, different locks and lock mechanism are installed. If you're interested in the topic or have questions about it, please write it in the comments and I'll make a new video about this. At this point, just a quick note on how to tell if your door protects well against burglars. The resistance classes go from resistance class 1, hardly any burglary protection, up to resistance class 6, highest burglary protection. For regular houses, the resistance classes 2 to 4 are particularly suitable. Of course, it always depends upon how much loot a burglar expects. So when you have a new door installed, pay attention to the resistance class. Now let's talk about the second point, the window frame. Even with windows of low resistance classes, it is difficult to break open a window with such a light tool, such for example, a screwdriver. As with doors, burglar resistant window frames come in resistance classes 1 to 6. I explain in detail how they differ in this video about burglar resistant windows. There, I also test the different window frames to see how long they can actually withstand burglars. As a rule of thumb, you could remember that resistance class 2 to 4 windows for houses usually provide quite good burglary protection. Again, of course, depending upon the house and the value of the expected loot inside. Now, the last point, the window glass. When burglars attack the window glass, it can look like this. And if you do not stop the burglars with burglar-resistant window glass, they can be inside the building within seconds. Here you can see a glass pane of resistant glass called P4A, which is attacked. A hole is created within seconds. In contrast to that, the attack on a burglar-resistant, for example, Silatec pane, in this case category P6B glass. After some time, even a second person comes in, but the glass still resists. The longer the burglar takes place, the more likely he's to give up. So make sure that your glass is as secure as the window frame. Let me summarize the most important points again. For effective burglary protection, mechanical measures are paramount. Your goal: to make the burglar take so long that he eventually gives up, or the police come and catch him before he gets inside. But how do you achieve this? Use mechanical burglary protection. Make sure your doors and windows are all secure and locked. Add electronic measures such as alarm systems or cameras to your burglary protection. And do not provide the burglar with tools by leaving tools or ladders outside. Now, you know a lot about electronic and mechanical burglary protection. You still have questions? Please feel free to leave them in the comments and I'll be so happy to answer them. If you want to learn more about burglary protection, you might want to check out my channel or click this video. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.